Hello students, today we will discuss the chapter complex number. What is complex number? Which numbers are called said to be the complex numbers? Come to first definition of the complex number. Definition of complex number. The set of complex numbers is given by C equal to Z such that Z is equal to X plus IY, what is I? I equal to root over of minus 1. What about X and Y? These are the two real numbers. Right? Set of complex numbers, and this is Z such that Z is equal to X plus IY and I is equal to root over of minus 1, where x and y are the two real numbers. Next is that, what about x and y? Here, if z is equal to x plus iy, then x is called the real part of z and y is called the imaginary part of z. Here, x is called the real part of z, that is RE bracketed Z, and Y is called imaginary part of Z, that is IM bracketed Z, real part of Z, and this is the imaginary part of Z. Now come to some question on it. Find real and imaginary part of following complex numbers. First bit, Z1 is equal to 1 plus 7i. Second bit, Z2 is equal to 3 minus 4i. Third bit, Z3 is equal to 8i. Fourth bit, Z4 is equal to 5. Look at, here the real part of Z1 is 1, imaginary part of Z1 is 7. Here is the real part of Z2 is 3, imaginary part of Z2 is minus 4. Real part of Z3, here is no real part, so we write the real part is 0. 0 plus 8i, real part is 0, imaginary part is 8. Here is 5 means 5 plus I 0. 5 means 5 plus I 0. So the real part is 5 and the imaginary part is 0. So real part of Z1, we write REZ1, real part of Z1 is 1 and imaginary part of Z1, IM of Z1 is equals to 7. Right. Look at, 5 is a real number and this can be expressed as 5 plus I 0, 5 plus I 0. So, every real number can be expressed in the complex number form. But every complex number 8i, 1 plus 7i, 3 minus 4i cannot be expressed in the complex number form, cannot be expressed in the real number form. This cannot be the real number. So, this is the first question is that, can every real number be a complex number? Yes, because 5 is a real number. It can be expressed in the complex number form. 5 ta gote real number, taku complex number express kari parle. But every complex number cannot be a real number. So, complex number set is the largest set and the set of real number, it is subset. So, come to its diagram. This is the N set, Venn diagram, and this is the Z set, the larger to that, and thereafter it is Q set, and thereafter it is set of real numbers R. And after that, the largest set is complex number set C. Right. Here, N, subset Z, subset Q, subset R, subset set of complex number C. So, this is the order of the sets or the larger from smaller to larger of the sum, the particular sets. Next is, we discuss, what about I? Look at, for this we discuss one question. Solve x square plus 1 equal to 0. Look at x square plus 1. X square plus 1 equal to 0 is a quadratic equation. Its power, highest power of x is 2, and therefore it is called the quadratic equation. So if it is quadratic equation, power is 2, then there are two values of x. X has two values. In case of third degree equation, cubic equation, third degree equation, the x has three values. In case of fourth degree equation, x has four values. So here x has two values. What are these values? Look at x square equal to minus 1, then x is equal to plus minus root over of minus 1. What about root over minus 1? This is taken as I, plus minus I. What is I? I is root over of minus 1, an imaginary number, an imaginary number. And this is derived from the word iota, derived from the word iota. Iota, Greek desor letter ru asichi, developed in named by named by mathematician Euler, E-U-L-E-R. So I is root over of minus 1, derived from the word iota. Iota is Greek lettered word, and it is developed by the mathematician Euler. Now tell me, what about I? Y is a negative number or I is a positive number? What about I? What about we say that about the I? I by ame kon koi pariba? It a negative number hebo or positive number hebo? Now come to order of I. Order of I. I is positive number or I is negative number? We discuss it here. What is the value of I? I equal to root over of minus 1. Case 1, if I less than 0, if I is negative number, if I is less than 0, then minus I greater than 0, minus I whole square greater than 0, I square greater than 0, minus 1 greater than 0. Can minus 1 will be more than 0? Minus 1 0 taru bada hoba ki? No, impossible. So our assumption is wrong. I cannot be less than 0. If you take I is less than 0, the value is minus 1 greater than 0, which is impossible. So we cannot take I is less than 0. So I less than 0 is not true. I less than 0 is not true. Case 2, if I greater than 0, then I square is greater than 0. If I greater than 0, I is positive. If I is positive, then square of this number is also positive. Square of a positive number is always a positive number. So I square greater than 0. If I square greater than 0, then minus 1 greater than 0. Is it also true? No, it is not true, impossible. If it is not possible, then I greater than 0 is not true. I greater than 0 is not true. Come to case 3, if I equal to 0, then I square equal to 0, minus 1 equal to 0. Minus 1 will be equal to 0? Not possible, impossible. not possible. Hence, I equal to 0 is not true. I is equal to 0 is not true. I is not less than 0. I is not greater than 0. I is not equal to 0. So, these three things case shows that in the number line, it is neither after 0, it is nor on the 0, it is not on the left side 0. Number line re, 0 ro right re, I cannot be exist. 0 ro left side re, I nahi. It is not also on the 0. So, what we say? I is not on real line. This is real line 0, 1, 2, all these. So, this is on the, not on the line. So, what about it? Hence, I is not, I is an imaginary number. Cannot be put in number line. Cannot be put in the number line. I 0, I got a imaginary number, real line re express kari paribani. So I is neither negative nor positive. Here is question to you. Here is question to you. Tell me whether 2i greater than I. True or false? True or false? What about say? True or false? Look at 2i. We cannot say which one is larger. 2i and I. Which one is in the number line? In the number line, where is I? Where is 2i? We cannot say. So, 2i is greater than I. We cannot say. 2i is less than I. We cannot say. Which one is strong? True. So, 2i greater than I. True coil be pullable. False coil be pullable. So, answer is cannot be said. Answer is cannot be said. Cannot be said. So, which one is larger? We cannot say whether 2i is larger or I is larger. This is neither true nor false. The only answer is cannot be said. Right. Now, come to next thing. Express the following numbers in the form of I. Express the following numbers in the form of I. In the form of I. Right. First bit, root over of -36. Second bit, root over of -25. Third bit, root over of -81. Look at, we write like this, root over -1 into root over 36, that is equal to I into 6i. Similarly, this is root over of 25 into root over of -1. Means 5i, root over -1 is I, root over 25 is 5. Similarly, it is root over of 81 into root over of -1, that is 9i. So, these are the expression of negative number, square root of a negative number in the form of I. Next is that, tell me, which one, here is you remember, see this derivation, which one is wrong, which one is the right derivation, you tell just. Root over of -36 into root over of -16 is equal to root over of, you take -36 nahi, you take 9, is equal to root over -9 into -16, that is equal to root over of 144, that is equal to 12. But C is another derivation, root over of -9 into root over of -16 is root -1 into root 9 into root -1 into root 16. Root -1 is I into root 9 is 3 into I into 4. So, it is 12 I square that is equals to minus 12. Which derivation is correct? Which derivation is correct? Look at this derivation is correct. This derivation is not correct because if you take two negative numbers, root over of two negative numbers, then you cannot assimilate as the root over of product of two numbers. So here is question. Jodi both negative thibo, tale gote single root over ku se asi paribo nahi. This is to be remembered. So here write in the rule for this, that root a into root b is equal to root over of a b if both are simultaneously not negative numbers. If both are simultaneously not negative numbers, if one negative one positive, then this rule will be maintained. If both positive, then this rule will be maintained. Both a negative b negative cannot satisfy the root over of a b condition, right? Next come to some complex numbers, some powers of I.